today we've got another look that's inspired by a Celtic holiday, which I can't pronounce, so I'll just put the name in the title, which is either above or below the video, I keep forgetting. Below the video, yeah. Point is, so you can see which holiday it is on there. Either way, it sort of represents the middle between summer and winter and also the start of the harvesting season. So I try to use colors that remind me of fruits mainly, like berries and apples, pears, things like that. And also huge lashes, which make me feel as if I'm going to fly off if I blink quickly enough. They're huge, I made them myself by the way, and they're not comfortable, but I do actually like how they look. So yeah, obviously this isn't a very wearable look, but I did really have a lot of fun doing it, so let's get started. This time I'm using the L'Oreal True Match Foundation, which I've seriously been using a lot recently. This is a shade beige, which is, well, for one, it's actually the exact perfect shade for my fake tan. And second, it's just a foundation that I know works. Like, I've been trying a lot of new foundations lately off screen, and pretty much, I don't know, I guess I'm sort of difficult with foundation, but this one just looks like skin, yet flawless, and it just stays in place, it stays matte for very long, and I love it. I just applied that with a Sigma foundation brush, then went on to the Maybelline Superstay Concealer in the shade Light, if I'm right. I'm not completely sure what shade name it was. I'll put everything down below in the description box as usual. You know, full names and all, and I'm also already grabbing my Peggy Sage powder, translucent loose powder, to immediately set this once I'm done. One thing I found out about this concealer is that you immediately need to, you know, spread it out. I'm using a nameless, brandless, eBay bought brush for that. But yeah, if you wait too long, it's just going to dry down and it's not going to blend properly anymore. So I'm just starting out with my eyes, immediately blending it out, then immediately powdering it with a Peggy Sage powder and a powder puff, also by Peggy Sage. And I'm also powdering the top of my eyelid. I didn't put concealer there, just foundation, but that'll just make sure that the eyeshadow will stay in place. And then I'm going on with highlighting the rest of my face. To be fair, I actually do very much like this concealer. I really love it for natural days when I'm only wearing a very little amount of concealer and just makeup overall. But admittedly, for a heavy makeup day like today, it's just not perfect. Like, it blends out to absolutely nothing pretty much. It just doesn't have the coverage that I'm looking for when I'm doing a more extreme look or a full face look. So yeah, I think I'm going to keep this one just for, you know, regular, barely any makeup days. And then once everything was on there, I just set it all with a big fluffy powder brush by Sigma and again the Peggy Sage powder. And then I'm also using Peggy Sage eyeshadow blush shaper thingies. They're just pigments in a little pan. You can pretty much use them for anything. I'm using a pale nude one as a highlighter underneath my eyes just to make it look a little bit more highlighted. I'm using another nameless, brandless brush. This one was bought off Born Pretty Store. It's really, really good. Sort of like a huge, gigantic pencil brush. And it's very, very soft as well. For shaping, I'm using a taupe shade on the same brush. And it's just perfect. It blends perfectly. It looks like skin. It's not too warm, not too cold. It's seriously the perfect shaping shade. Surprisingly difficult to pronounce. Either way, I'm also shaping my nose and also my jawline. I usually leave my forehead alone because for some reason top of that is always darker than the rest anyway. Sort of a natural shape. And then I'm using an orange shade by Peggy Sage. And I'm using a large contour brush by Sigma. I always use this as powder brush. Or powder brush. The blush brush. Powder blush brush. Yeah. And I'm just pretty much blending it along with the shaper. And then I'm moving on to a little gold pen. This is just a half pen by Peggy Sage. And I'm using that as a highlighter on an Abilene brush, which doesn't have a name on it, but I use it for when I want heavy duty highlighter. And I nearly knocked over my camera. Yeah. And then for my eyebrows, I actually use purple. Because I was going for a fantasy look anyway, and I like purple. It's just, you know, it reminds me of berries and grapes and stuff like that. So it's perfect for a harvest theme. So what I did first was just comb my eyebrows upwards with a spoolie by Peggy Sage. And then I just used a nail art brush to fill them in first with the shimmery darker purple shade. Which actually the shimmer doesn't show up on the eyebrows, which is nice. And then I did the edges of it, like the point with the other
yeah, the other purple shade is sort of more of a matte shade and sort of cooler, but it's sort of more pigmented than this one. You'll see that in a moment. I'm sort of making it very pointy and sharp and just, you know, curved upwards. Because for some reason, whenever I want to do a fantasy look or a fairy-like look, I do Goblin King eyebrows, like the Goblin King from the movie Labyrinth. I love that movie. And I also love the eyebrows, so yeah, that's why I always end up doing my eyebrows like this whenever I do a fantasy look. And I also decided to do some purple shader, shaper. Yeah. As you can see, this is just, it's a cooler tone of purple than the other purple, than the shimmery one. But it's still very nice, and because the other shaper is already below it, it just blends out like a dream. It's seriously easy to blend this way. And yeah, it would be blendable on, you know, just normal skin without the other powder, but the other taupe, the taupe color just makes it a lot easier. So I'm just using that over all the other shapers. And then I'm going to use a little Real Techniques fluffy sort of powder brush with the nude shade to blend it out around my nose a little bit more, so it just blends in with the skin. I'm keeping the above edge sharp. And then I also wanted some glitter, because fantasy and glitter is, you know, yeah, that's just a thing. Like, I always want glitter when I do a fantasy look. This is actually a glitter spray by Hema, which was from an old Christmas collection. I'm just applying it as a highlighter all over my face pretty much, and accidentally breathing it in and getting it all over my floor and my clothes. And I'm going to find glitter for the rest of the week everywhere. And then I use the Real Techniques brush to just blend it out. And you can use any type of glitter. This is cosmetic glitter, so it's supposedly eye safe, and it's also very finely milled, so it's very nice. But any glitter will do. Then I use the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in the shade White, combined with an Abilene Concealer Brush to prime my eyelid. I'm doing that because the first eyeshadow shade I'm going to use is actually not a very good one. I didn't have the right shade in the Peggy Sage colors, so I used one by BH Cosmetics instead of the 120 color palette, but this one unfortunately wasn't very pigmented. It works fine with one of these old-fashioned eyeshadow brushes by Peggy Sage, and then an EcoTools brush. And over top, of course, with the white base, then it does show up, but, you know, on its own, it's pretty much invisible, unfortunately. For the rest, I didn't need a base. I just went in right in with the orange shade that I also used on my cheeks, but this time I'm using it in my crease with a blender brush by Sigma. It used to have a name and a number, but then I washed it 500 times, and now it no longer has a name and a number on it, so I can't tell you which one exactly it is. But it's just a large fluffy blender, and I'm blending this shade quite far upwards because I still want it to be visible in the end. And then I'm using more of a burgundy purplish shade in the crease with a smaller blending brush. This one is by BH Cosmetics. Very soft brush, and yeah, just wipe off the brush, then blend it, and then use the big Sigma brush to blend it some more. I also applied a little bit more orange above the burgundy because I really did want the orange to show up. They're both colors that remind me of fruit and of harvesting season, and, you know, I just really like the combination of them, and I really wanted the ombre effect to be visible. So yeah, I just kept reapplying the colors and blending them out until I was satisfied, and then went on to highlighter. Well, you know, eyebrow highlight, obviously there's already enough glitter everywhere else. But I used it on a short shader, just a white eyeshadow by Peggy Sage, short shader by Sigma, and applied it underneath my elongated, weirdly shaped eyebrow. And then just use the blending brush by Sigma again to blend it all together so it looks nice and smooth. And then I use the brush that came with the Urban Decay Vice XX palette, just with the same burgundy shade and the same orange shade as I used just now. But now I'm just applying it on the outer corner and just blending it all together. And I'm also blending it a little bit upwards towards the crease just to connect it all. And then I'm using the brush that came with the Urban Decay Electric Palette along with some of the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk on my waterline. It would actually be easier to use a regular small white eye pencil, but I was too lazy to grab one, so yep. Then for eyeliner, I use the Crayola Aqua Color Interference in the shade of green. It's really, really beautiful. However, I did actually notice afterwards, when I read the packaging, that you're not actually supposed to use this directly around the eyes. Yeah, I didn't get any issues from it, like, it was perfectly fine. I don't have sensitive eyes, luckily. However, if you want to play it safe, don't use this, use an actual eyeliner, because they're probably not warning you for nothing, I guess. But yeah, I just applied a green eyeliner. Because again, green also reminds me of fruits, or you could hear my phone in the background. I forgot to switch it off. I'll just knock it to the other side of the room now. Okay. Phone is gone, and then I just applied a little bit of a wing on the other corner as well. And I used green eyeshadow to just make my lower lash line a little bit more green too. I didn't dare to use the liner for that because I was scared I was going to screw it up. And then for highlighting the inner corner, I used the HEMA glitter spray on a pencil brush by Sigma and just carefully applied it there. It's not a good idea to try to spray it directly into the inner corner, I can tell you that from experience. It also gets into contact lenses. And then I used Peggy Sage eyelash glue and these eyelashes. I actually made these myself from very cheap eBay lashes and some feathers and then also some nail polish. It actually worked, but they're pretty stiff and they were really difficult to apply. And they were very uncomfortable, but that had probably had more to do with the length of the feathers. However, I do think it looks very cool. If I'd go to a fantasy fair, I probably wouldn't wear them, but for photos and such, it's really, really fun. Then for my lips, I used the Makeup Revolution lipstick in the shade... which one was it? Unicorns Unite Magical. I tried to make it an ombre, so I applied it lightly on my entire lip, then a little bit more heavily on the inner parts of my lip, and then just blended out the edges with my fingers, as you can see me doing here. And it just creates a nice ombre effect, which I think suits very well with the fantasy theme. And then that's the final result. I really had a lot of fun doing this. I love playing with like used lashes, and I love playing with bright colors. I hope you enjoyed watching this. If you did, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you'd like, you can also subscribe to my channel. For now, I hope you enjoyed watching this. Thank you very much for watching. And see you next time. Bye!